Mercado Vial TV, un mundo de máquinas.
Nos vinimos acá a Tecmaco, un día un poquito nublado. Estamos en una presentación, un lanzamiento acá en el país, un nuevo tipo de equipo, lo que sería una pilotera, pero sobre el chasis de una pala retro, una 4CX, la más grande de ellos.
This behind me is our piling master. It is a 4CX standard machine with a back end here for piling purposes. The machine itself can drill down to 14 meters in depth. We have four diameter sizes for the tools at the back end, 350, 450, 600 and also 900.
What is the application? Because this is a new concept.
The original concept was always featured around the standard 4CX because of the machine's mobility and versatility when it comes to one roading around the site, speed of application. And mobilization as well. You don't need a huge amount of transport. It was revolutionary for the piling industry and the market as well, because at present nothing exists in the piling industry that is on rubber tires. So everything conventionally or historically has been track mounted machines. So if you put my machine versus a track machine for mobility, mines will leave that in its dust, and really it's a very very quick machine. So again, the advantages of my machine over the large conventional piling machines is its ability to be able to get to and from sites and move around sites. Back home in the UK, we require what you're standing on now, which could be considered a piling mat. So this mat needs to be designed. My machine doesn't have a classification, so it doesn't require this mat, and this mat can be very expensive for the main contractors. So it offers great savings when it comes to the site set up for the piling works to be executed. The machine itself has an overall depth of 14 meters, and that can be achieved in all of the diameter sizes and tools for the machine. We have the King Post system at the back end of the machine, which gives you a 180 degree area in which to pick up pile position. We also have the stabilizing feet at the back end of the machine. The machine's weight is 11.7 ton in transport, and with the auger on, it's slightly heavier. We have counterbalance at the front end on the 6-in-1 shovel.
You have some counterweight because of the heavier back end of the equipment. That's standard, and that's the way the machine's so equilibrated, because we saw it in the transportation and it goes very smoothly.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Yes, that's true. It's transportation mode, obviously, with the augers off and in the front shovel, is still capable of 40 kph. It's remarkably maneuverable and roads really well. You asked about the verticality.
Yeah.
So verticality is actually controlled from the display unit between the operator's legs. Once verticality is achieved over the first meter or so, the boom can be locked down into pilot mode. And over the first meter and a half of the pile or the bore being drilled out, it's highly important to make little adjustments to keep the verticality, because that can act as your guide on the way down. So seven sections on the Kelly bar itself, and we use a Hardox 400 on the keyways on the Kelly bar itself. So it's a pretty robust system.
Yeah, about the three different steering.
Three different steering?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, for road, you would have it on two-wheel drive for transporting it around on the roadways. In site or on site, you can have four-wheel drive, or you could have crab steer as well. Crab steer is a fantastic option if you're in a very restricted area with lots of piles that you need to avoid as well. Because remember, once you pile pile, or once you drill the pile in concrete and reinforcement, then you have to dodge these piles to go on to your next position. So crab has been vital with this machine. Again, all part of its maneuverability on site versus the larger tracked machines. This machine really is in a league of its own.